You don't believe in the boogeyman? You should.
You could see it, the damage that was done, because the cheekbone, it wasn't there anymore. It was just kind of
Why would he want this?
Well, I don't think he, if he had forethought, I don't think he'd have done it. But they start going, and watch the left hand of Boogaard. He works it, and then he finally throws the right. Boom. There's a, that's too much. That just flushed to the jaw.
It comes to Jones, and Jones gets tripped up there by Boogaard, and that is not good.
Fairly stable here, except for some of their lineup changes. Here's the hit by Boogaard. Boom! That's what you call finishing your check. You know, Boogaard was a help.
Thank you.
his head down a little bit there. Gillies, this is his first NHL game. He didn't get a chance to fight in the preseason because, oh, and that's it. Oh, goodness. Good night. Boogaard finishes this.
I think enough said. We'll be right back.
First round draft pick. Oh, here we go.
Boogaard right off of the whistle.
Well, Brennan was acquired just for this reason, and Boogaard's not too afraid to jump in on something like this either.
Oh.
Wow. That's what you call decisive.
I think that one speaks for itself.
And just pops him. He lays him. Oh, there it is.
Tough one.
Off the draw just outside the blue line. Now Boogaard drops him again, this time with Fedora.
Well, no one wants to be what's called a highlight reel. And right now Boogaard has one highlight reel on Brennan. See if he's going to make Fedora another highlight reel.
It kind of looks that way. They may not have any clothes left by the time they're done. Back to the headshot by Boogaard. Eric Bogard's going to be one tired man when this one's over.
He is. They're both swinging for the fences.
Wow. And again, Mike, it was right off the Boogaard.
Oh, and they're backed up.
They're up.
Oh.
Brookbank and Boogaard.
Two very big men going at it.
There's an elbow. They don't need that for a fight.
You guys both have pretty good moves. Boogaard, this is his third fight of the year. He had two against Anaheim. He tried to fight Jason Weimer last night, but Weimer was smart not to take that. Oh, boy! That is a highlight reel hit right there. Oh, you can see. Boogaard's highlight reeled a lot of guys this year.
It was going to happen eventually. It wasn't going very well for Vandermeer. We'll be back. Wild up 3-0.
Look at the reach. Boogaard comes in, and he just catches him right on the chin, and down goes Vandermeer.
It got past Pascal Dupuis.
Pascal
took something up high.
Might have got an elbow there.
And now Boogaard says, I want to talk to you about that.
Oh, boy. That's a...
Spiller took a spill.
That was a little one-sided there. A little one-sided.
Boogaard and McGrath are going to go. Let's change some heavyweights.
Certainly can get you into trouble unless you start throwing bombs with that left. After that, basically flailing in the wind. Don't know, hold it again.
the right with that long reach. Boogaard missing, so does Kochi. The two big men growing exhausted. As Kochi takes a couple off the back of the head, these two well-conditioned athletes go on, and a vicious uppercut missed by Boogaard. He lands a soft one there, and Kochi responds with the right. A fight that won't end, and now David Kochi starts to give it to Derek Boogaard at the end.
What a scrap.
But obviously it worked, and now...
Now the fans are calling out Boogaard. Boogaard saying, I can't wait to go on the ice to knee somebody else.
That could like end your season is one punch you can crush your face.
His intense stare, imposing size, and powerful knockouts had earned him a chilling nickname.
Boogeyman. That's a name that's gonna stick with NHL tough guys for years, you know.
This kid is a monster, Boogaard. 6'7", 245 pounds, and he just got Gillies with a haymaker.
So you want to be an enforcer in the NHL?
You don't believe in the Boogeyman?